السلام عليكم
ورحمة الله.
الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلي وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحابه. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. ما بعد. Inshallah, I'll continue the book of the excellence, righteous deeds for a few minutes. Then, inshallah, I will start the story of Yusuf alayhi salatu salam until the brothers come. There is a chapter about the excellence of dua from a calamity. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَا مِنْ عَبْدٍ تُصِيبُهُ مُصِيبَةٌ فَيَقُولُ إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ اللَّهُمَّ أَجُرْنِي فِي مُصِيبَتِي وَخْلُفْ لِي خَيْرًا مِنْهَا وَخْلُفْ لِي خَيْرًا مِنْهَا إِلَّا أَجَرَهُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى فِي مُصِيبَتِي وَأَخْلَفَ لَهُ خَيْرًا مِنْهَا. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when a person suffers from a calamity and utters, إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ اللَّهُمَّ أَجُرْنِي فِي مُصِيبَتِي وَخْلُفْ لِي خَيْرًا مِنْهَا. إِنَّا لِلَّهِ, we belong to Allah. وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ, and to Him we shall return. O Allah, compensate me in my affliction, recompense my loss, and give me something better in exchange for it. Who narrated this hadith? Salama رضي الله تعالى عن, the wife of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. She said, when my husband Abu Salama passed away before the marriage, her marriage to Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, she said, when I lost my husband, عليكم السلام, Abu Salama, I repeated the same dua, the same supplication. I repeated the same supplication as the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had commanded me to do. So Allah, and she said, subhanallah, she said, who's better than Abu Salama? She said the dua. Sometimes you don't expect. Of course, it doesn't mean that you don't believe that Allah can do. No doubt. I believe Allah can do, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah can give me someone who's better than my husband, my son, my wife. But subhanAllah, she said, yeah, something came to her mind. From where I can find a man better than Abu Salama, my husband? He was a pious man. She said, so Allah bestowed upon me a better substitute than him. Not only than him, than everyone. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. She became the wife of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So this is the way of the Muslim. If you have a calamity, okay, you lost your car, you lost your job, you failed an exam, something happened to you you don't like, then say, inna lillah wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Allahumma ajurni fi musibati, O Allah, give me a reward because of this calamity. وَخْلُفْنِي خَيْرًا مِنْهَا, and exchange me with something better. And you should believe, alaykum salam, you should believe that. Maybe. You are working a business. Then you lost your shop. You lost something. And you think, this is the best I'm working for day and night. I was making a long study, maybe 1 year, 2 years, 3 years. You lost this shop, you lost this item, or you lost this, whatever. Say this dua, Allah will replace you something better. طيب. Or sometimes you work hard to join this college. Okay, wallahi, I'm working day and night. I am studying and private tuitions and everything to join faculty of medicine. Okay, then they did not accept me because of very strong competition to have a chair in this college. And then later you join another college, not medicine. Subhanallah, after saying this dua, Allah will give you the khair, the good things in the other option. And subhanallah, In Islam, alhamdulillah, Allah gave us a lot of things, okay, replacing the haram things. Imagine without Islam, without faith. What will you do if you have a calamity? Committing suicide, if it is a very strong, if it is a shock, people commit a suicide. Alaykum salam. Or some people do haram things. They drink khamr, for example. They drink khamr. Or some people, if they have a problem, they listen to music. Yalla, let's go to find any party, anything, any haram, and to forget. This concept from shaitan, to forget. Okay, tamam, forget, but not through something haram. Forget by using, by reading Quran, saying the adhkar, joining pious people. Tayyib, so in Islam, alhamdulillah, we have very good things. Very good things. إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ اللَّهُمَّ أَجُرْنِي فِي مُصِيبَتِي وَأَخْلُفْ لِي خَيْرًا مِنْهَا. And also the other hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to say, الحمد لله على كل حال. If there's something that he doesn't like, he used to say, الحمد لله على كل حال. And if there is something he likes, he says, عليه الصلاة والسلام, الحمد لله الذي بنعمته تتم الصالحات. If you have something you don't like, you say, Alhamdulillah ala kulli hal. For anything, I'm saying, all praise to Allah. For anything. And if you have something you like, you say, Alhamdulillah, all praise to Allah. Alladhi bi ni'mati tatimu salihat. Because of Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Only because of Him, that we have the salihat, yani the good things. Perfect. We got the perfection because of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then there is a chapter about الطاعون, the excellence of death with plague. طاعون, it means a disease, very dangerous disease, spread among people, very an infectious disease. Goes in the people very quickly and in a very dangerous way. This is called الطاعون. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, الشهداء خمسة. الشهداء, the martyrs are five types of people. المطعون والمبطون والغريق وصاحب الهد والشهيد في سبيل الله. The martyrs are of five kinds. One who dies of plague, one who dies of disease of his belly, the drowned, one who dies under the debris of construction, and one who dies while fighting in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Another narration, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked the companions, radiallahu anhu, whom do you reckon to be martyr amongst you? Who are the shaheed? The companions said, من قتل في سبيل الله فهو شهيد. The one who was killed in Allah's way, he's shaheed. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إذن شهداء أمتي قليل. In that case, the martyrs among my people would be few. If you consider those who die while fighting in jihad, they are shaheed, then they are few. Because subhanAllah, the fighting in this ummah not like the previous ummah. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, he who is killed in the way of Allah is shaheed. He who dies naturally in the cause of Allah is shaheed. He who dies of plague is shaheed. And he who dies of a belly disease is a shaheed. And he who is drowned is a shaheed. طيب. Let's see these categories. المطعون. What does it mean, المطعون? المطعون, the one who dies... who dies in a plague, in a disease, widespread disease, okay, pandemic disease, okay, then he is shaheed. He is shaheed, and there is a rule for the plague that it is, if it is in a country, it is not allowed for anyone to leave the place. And if you are outside this country, it is not allowed to enter the country. and what is called now, yeah, and if you notice in the hospital, sometimes you'll find on the door of this patient, it is written isolation. Okay? This concept from Islam. This concept from Islam. So you have to respect this because this is part of Islam. If there is a patient, the doctors tell you that don't visit him because he has a disease, can be infectious. So don't visit. Don't visit. And also it is not allowed for him to go outside to visit the other rooms and other people. Not allowed for him to visit his family. This concept from Islam. And there was a discussion among the companions when they, at the time of Umar, radiallahu ta'ala an, something called Ta'un Imwas. Ta'un Imwas in Fi Sham. Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu was in Medina. The Khilafa was in Medina at the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The time of Umar, sorry, the time of Abu Bakr, time of Umar, time of Uthman, all of these years, the Khilafah was in Medina. At the time of Ali radiallahu ta'ala, because there was a problem, so at the beginning it was in Medina, then later he went to Iraq. The Khilafah, it means the leader of the Muslim Ummah, the leadership went to Iraq at the time of Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu ta'ala. So Umar al-Khattab left Medina toward Sham, a place called Imwas. Okay, and Abu Ubaidah ibn al-Jarrah was there. Abu Ubaidah, Amr ibn al-Jarrah was there. Of course, they don't know that there is a disease there or not. Okay, but when they reach, before reaching Imwas, before reaching that place, the news came to them that there is a disease, there is Ta'un, plague. Umar stopped, radiallahu ta'ala. What to do now? Should we go or stay? So, Umar radiallahu ta'ala started to consult the companions. Okay? So, some of the companions and some of the Muslims, they said, we should go. We should not stop. Khalas, this is from Allah. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to test us with this disease, khalas, the disease will come to us. If Allah doesn't want, the disease will not touch us. So we should go. Go inside the country. Other companions said, no, we should not go inside because also this is part of Islam to protect yourself from the infectious diseases. The Prophet ﷺ said, فِرَّ مِنَ الْمَجِدُونَ فِرَارَكَ مِنَ الْأَسَدِ. You should run away from the Al-Majidun, also a kind of disease which is infectious. As you are escaping from a lion. So the companions were discussing, and Umar, yallah, one group discussing one group, one meeting, another meeting, third meeting. يعني, it is very sensitive, and because يعني, if we enter this city, maybe we lose the whole army. طيب, and it will be a disaster for the Muslim Ummah. Subhanallah, Abdurrahman ibn Auf was not with them. Then he came. What you are discussing? They told him. Then Abdurrahman ibn Auf said, Khalas, I have the hadith from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if you hear that the plague is in one country, don't enter. And if you are inside the country, don't get out. خلاص. أمر خلاص رضي الله تعالى عنه. And أبو عبيدة من الجراح said to عمر, يعني, are you escaping from the قدر of Allah? This is decree from Allah. Why you are escaping? عمر said, نفر من قدر الله بقدر الله. We are escaping from the قدر of Allah, the decree for Allah, because of the decree of Allah, the قدر of Allah. Allah told us to follow the reasons. طيب. So this is المطعون والمبطون. What does mean مبطون? مبطون from the word البطن. البطن. And anatomy, this, the abdomen. The abdomen. Okay. So some scholars like النووي رحمه الله said It means if the person dies because of diarrhea, you know what will happen if the person is has diarrhea, okay? He will get dehydrated. Then he will die. If you don't give him medicine, if you don't give him, replace him with liquids, he will die. Subhanallah. So if the person dies because of the diarrhea, he is shaheed. Other scholars said, any disease of the stomach or of the abdomen. Yeah, for example, ascites. What's mean of ascites? You notice this when the person has a heart problem. Okay, the heart is not beating and is weak. What will happen? The water accumulates in the body. So subhanAllah, the abdomen will be, his belly will be big. So some scholars said any disease of the abdomen. Abdomen and anatomy, the whole part. Because stomach means only the stomach, المعدة. But abdomen, the whole part. والغريق, drowned in the sea or inside the well, also this is shaheed. This is shaheed. وصاحب الهدم, صاحب الهدم. If you are, yeah, and the people, for example, they are in the building and subhanAllah, the building collapsed. People who died, shaheed. I think in the building near the Burj al-Tahrir, Al-Wataniya building in Kuwait City. Souq al-Wataniya. You know Souq al-Wataniya? Yes. Near the Burj al-Tahrir. Okay. Yeah, maybe this is before 40 years or something like this. Subhanallah, when they were building it, it collapsed. I don't know, 100 or 300 people passed away. Subhanallah. So the Muslims consider as shaheed. The Muslims consider it as shaheed. Yes. Late on the question? Sure. Inshallah.
if the people are committing sin inside that building, for example, they are drinking alcohol or drinking the zina, and the building collapsed, still they will be considered as shaheed?
From where you can find a person without sins? Everyone has sins. Mm. Okay. So generally, Muslims will be shaheed. Muslims will be martyrs. Shaheed. But it is mentioned by some scholars that if the person, for example, doing something haram, okay, and because of the haram, for example, he's driving over speed, and everyone telling him this is wrong, this is haram. The maximum speed is 120. He's driving 200. Then he had the car accident or the fire came and his body burned. He said he will not consider as shaheed because he killed himself. He killed himself. So this is different than the example. طيب. So وصاحب الهدم شهيد. وشهيد في سبيل الله. The one who was fighting and he was killed in the battle between Muslim and Kafir. Between Muslim and Kafir, then he is shaheed. Then he is shaheed. And and also another narration, المرأة تموت بجمع. When the lady, the woman, dies بجمع. What does it mean جمع? When we say جمع in Arabic, what does it mean جمع الصلاة?
Together,
to join. So what does it mean جمع? It means because she is pregnant, two persons, جمع. She and the baby. So the one who dies because of pregnancy, also she is shaheed. And also during delivery, giving birth, also she is shaheed. And also another narration, wadatul jamb, that a kind of disease called datul jamb. They say, subhanAllah, it is like swellings at the side of the body. Okay, yani like some scholars say, something like cancer. A lot of swellings because the lymph nodes, something like this. Also, they will be shaheed. والسل, Sul. Sul means the TB, tuberculosis. Also the one who dies because of tuberculosis. And subhanAllah, TB is a dangerous disease. Yeah, maybe now, alhamdulillah, it is relatively controlled, but it is a dangerous disease, the TB. So these are the types of disease, shaheed, and there are more. Okay, but when we say shaheed, it means shaheed in the akhirah, not in the dunya. Shaheed, يعني, they say there are three types of shaheed. Shaheed in dunya, martyr of dunya. Number two, martyr of the akhirah. Number three, martyr, dunya and akhirah. The martyr of dunya, the shaheed of dunya, the one who is, for example, fighting to show people that I am strong. Fighting only to defend his tribe and his name, family name. So he is shaheed of dunya. Of course, we don't know his intention. But he is considered shaheed only in the dunya. What is the meaning of shaheed of dunya? Yeah, for example, he is fighting to defend his tribe or to show that I am strong. Of course, we don't know. So if he is killed, if we find him killed in the battlefield, خلاص, we will deem him as a shaheed. It means we should not wash him. And we bury him with his clothes, with the blood. Why? Because we consider him shaheed, but where? In dunya. In the akhirah, Allah will punish him. The second, shaheed of the akhirah. Shaheed of the akhirah, like the type we mentioned. Most of the type that we mentioned, the late, during giving birth, the pregnant woman, the one who dies because of plague. Okay? They will get the reward of shaheed in the akhirah. And the third type, shaheed in dunya akhirah, the one who is fighting the cause of Allah. So he will be, we consider him as a shaheed in dunya, we deal him as a shaheed in dunya, and also in the akhirah he will get the reward of the shaheed. He will get the reward of shaheed. Okay.